Welcome to the testing world. In previous session, we have seen what is API and what are the different type of APIs. We are going to start API testing by using Python. And here we are going to test REST API. Before this session, we must have good knowledge of Python. We should be aware about how we can play with JSON file and also request module. So these are the prerequisite of this session. In this session, I'll make a GET request. Whatever the response which is coming from the server, I'll pick that response, and as of now, I'm just going to display that response. First of all, I have just moved to my project here in the PyCharm, and I have created a project with the name API Automation. Now, before moving forward, we need some packages to be installed. So what all the packages we need? So minimum we need a package with the name request, and we need a JSON package, and we need JSON path. JSON is by default coming with Python, so we need not to install it. We need to go for the request and JSON path. For that, I'm just moving to command prompt, and we know how to install. So pip install request. So first of all, I'm installing request package. So if we already have that package, it's not going to install any new package. But if we don't have, it's going to install that package. So here it shows you already have the package, but it's not updated one. So if you want to go for the updated one, we can use pip install hyphen u request. So I'm going to install a request package, which is updated one. So that is done. So first step is done where we have installed request package. I'm just clearing screen. Then I need to go for the JSON path. So I'm writing like pip install JSON path. Again, I'm using hyphen u. If it is already there, upgrade to the latest one. So it shows we already have the JSON path. We need not to install it. But if you want to install it, you just need to mention this line, and it will install JSON path. So that's a minimum requirement. Once you install this, I want to check in my project. So I'm just going to the project. Here we have file, settings, and project interpreter that comes under the project level. And here I just want to check, do I have a request? So that is the request package we are having. Also, I have installed JSON path. So let me check, do we have JSON path? Yes, we have JSON path. So we already have JSON path. Now we install JSON path and request. We know for working, first of all, I'm going to the project. Now right click on the project, new, and I'm creating a directory. And here in the directory, I just mentioned get request. So first of all, I want to hit only get request. A folder is created. Inside that, I'm just creating a Python file, fetch user data. You can give any name to this file. I'm just creating a file, Python file, with the name fetch user data. It's a Python file. Now we are ready to write code, but question here is which API you are going to hit. So I'm just taking you a website with the name req.res.in. Here we are going to get free REST API. So we can use these free REST API for our testing purpose. I'm just scrolling down. Here you will get, you find a first request. We can make a GET kind of request. I just click on this. It shows that is a URL. In response, you are going to get 200 code, and you are going to get all the users. First of all, I want to generate a URL for that. So That's a base URL. I've just copied that. And I'm coming here for get request. That's a base URL. And that's the relative URL. So that's a complete URL or URI for this get request. And here it is showing /2, so I make it correct. Just copied this. Now going to my test case, and here I'm going to use a variable. So API URL. So I'm creating a variable like URL, and that's the data. And I'm putting into the double quotes because that's a string. Now, to make a request to the server and to get response from the server, we are going to use a request module. So I'm saying import request. So here we are getting this request. Now, to make a request, so send get request. We are going to use request dot get. And what's the URL? So we have stored into the URL variable. Now, when we send this request to the server, we are going to get some response. I'm just holding whatever we are getting in a variable response. And as of now, I'm just printing it. So I just printed it. It's a very simple program in which we are just sending a get request with the URL. We are getting some response. I'm just printing it. So execute this file. It is sending a request to the server, and we are getting some response from the server. So it shows, yes, you are getting a response. So we send a request, we got some response, and we printed this response variable, which is showing that response 200. It's not showing the response content at all. So as of now, what we have done, we made a request to the server, and we are getting some response, which is stored into the response variable. Now, I want to display response. So here I'm coming, and we want to display response content. I'm coming here and response dot, and we have a parameter with the name content. So I'm just picking the content of the response. Control S. I'm just running it again. And this time you will notice we are getting this complete response. So if you check it here, page 2, per page 3, total 12. And if I show you here, it shows the same thing. Page 2, per page 3, total 12. So this is the response we are fetching here in the Python. So if you notice, we have only 2 or 3 lines of code through which we are able to hit a request, a get request, and we are able to fetch and display response which is coming from the server. So that's the first request we make, and in this session we need to cover how we can make get request. So we made this request. How we can pick response? So whatever the response is coming, we are storing into the response object, and then we are displaying the response content. For that we have used response.content. In the same way, we have few more options, like I want to fetch header of the response. So we know that in response we are going to get body and the header. So if you want to fetch header of the response, so I'm just running, and here it will show content as well as header. So if you check it here, that is the header we are getting of the response. So we are going to fetch body as well as header. Here we have seen how we can fetch body as well as header. So here in this session we have seen how we can make a GET request, how we can pick response, how we can display response. That's all we have for this session. Thanks for watching this video.